Okay, so it's windy, but I figured it's supposed to be in the 90s. It went from being cold and rainy to 90s. Anyway, so it looks like a lush forest right now, so I figured I'd better make a video showing you. This is right off my front step. I had to cut that grass back because it was, see how the rose is doing sad? The grass was over in it. So this, we'll just do the front step right now. That's taller lavender, and that's some shorter lavender that's blooming now. And I gotta cut that yarrow back. It's crazy growing through the chair. Those are mints in there. And look, not yellow hollyhocks. I got some red ones up here. But look, that's filled in right there. Alright, so, and we got our first lily. Maybe I should mess with the camera settings. It seems awfully bright. My roses, they get beat up here and don't do as well. I haven't figured it out yet, but since I moved here, it's been windy, and I supposedly moved from a wind tunnel area. So, I'm trying to get something other than yellow hollyhocks growing in there. Oregano, pineapple mint, and that's lavender. Lavender. See, it's like a jungle, huh? I gotta, it's getting a little out of control. I'm gonna leave it hanging out for a little while, though. The lavender. See, these roses always bloom and look beat up like this. I'm not sure. So the heat's coming on, like I said, so I haven't had to have my sprinklers on but once this year so far. See? It's like a jungle. My cherries are turning. I wish I would have got the sweet cherries. Instead, I got the tart ones. See my herb sign here? It doesn't stay turned. So, my forest, my jungle. Okay, now, I put a clematis in here because hanging baskets cost, I don't know, they cost me a lot of money. I don't do good with them. So I'm hoping the clematis, I can get it to go up here and look cool. And I'm trying to get stuff to grow in there. Alright. Oh, there's my comfrey. I'm going to have to harvest them. The grapevines are starting to grow on the side here, and I took out this bed. I'm gonna let grass grow in there. Concord grape. Concord. The Virginia creeper vine's growing good. I may have to trim it back once the grapevines get going good. So, and then there's a seedless Concord, green grape. I want to get some climbing tea roses or something in here so that I have blooms throughout the summer, because these guys, the antiques, only bloom once. But there's a tea growing right here. And then I'm going to try to get this to fill in with just seeds that I have. There's a tea growing there. See, but they're not stout. No, I'll show you something interesting over here. Well, there's my compost pile, still out of control. Bamboo, I gotta get that peach tree that started growing out of the corner there. If anybody wants it, I'm serious, we can dig it out. Just get some root start though. We'll dig it out and plant it in your yard. So, my shade plants were doing good. See, that one's doing awesome. This one was doing as good until that last storm, and then bam! Not sure what happened. So, see, the backyard's really filled in a lot. Oh, I forgot to show you the apple tree. I should thin out some of them apples. I thought they wouldn't come in as good this year. Dang, there's a lot though. Oh, I put some pallet things up there because that vine decided to start taking off. My peach tree, I did thin some out. I need to get on the ladder though and thin more. Oregano with some flowers mixed in with garlic and onions and the lemon balm and the berry plants. Oh, I missed a weed. See, I took out a lot of raspberries, and that's going to be a perennial bed. That's what's growing in there. Right now it looks... I'm going to let the garden area be like a perennial bed, but with vegetables. I'm going to try it. So my sage is flowering. I let the spinach go to seed because I want to collect the seed from it. See, that's filling in good right there. Looks a little messy right now, and I transplanted those lilies because they were in the rose bush falling over. And then once this area over here fills in, it's going to look nice. You just got to be able to envision it. I transplanted this rose bush and it's growing, so if all goes well, it'll go up this trellis and this one will go across here, and then we'll have blooms. I'm gonna have to trim the grapevine because it's doing so good. And then this hammock here, I've fallen asleep in twice since the rain stopped. But it was $9.98. Not kidding, $9.98. And this little perennial bucket planter is doing good. And see, this took off, so I needed to put a trellis thing back up so it could grow on there. You gotta be able to envision it. I fought the urge. I had to go to the nursery today to get some hanging baskets for my friend's house, and I fought the urge to buy more shade plants. So it's gonna, if you can vision it, it's gonna do nicely. But peas were supposed to be growing up that. Oh no, I would think that peas would like lots of moisture, but maybe they didn't. I don't know. Well, and it was cool too, and I thought peas like the coolness too. I don't know what's up. Too bad you guys can't smell this. It, for those of you who love roses, here, I'll get you up close. Sniff. Inhale. Inhale. Oh, I got this. Yes, I put my head in the plant. And this is a honeysuckle that grows on its own. Ooh, I gotta get that nest off of there. But anyways, and these berries, when the birds eat it, they get like drunk. And then they hit my window sometimes. Bam! Crazy! It's entertaining because they don't... None of them have ended up dead on the ground. Closing the gate. I'm so tired. Truth be told, I'm very tired today. I'm trying to just make myself move, get stuff done that I had to get done. I did that, except for this yarrow. I need to thin it out. See, going through the chairs. Okay, inhale. Lavender. I like this taller lavender. Anyhow, oh, I didn't show you this sign. The neighbor had this sitting on the side of his yard, and I says, can I have that? So I put free on there with one of those washable ones. I don't know if it comes off or not, but then when all the free stuff's gone, I put the sign on there. Hasn't worked so far, but it was worth a shot. That's just the signs for the stuff that I just have on the co-op to try to sell. Yeah. I had to thin that out so much that now there's only like a wisp of grass. Look how thick that one is. I'm gonna have to probably thin that one out. Look how thick. That doesn't have any more room to grow. And look, Mother's Day flowers. the local ward over here. And then there's one by the rose bush by the front porch, and they're doing good. Hey, look at the neighbor's cactus. They're blooming. Alrighty. Oh, so the hollyhocks start growing through the cracks, and the neighbor had made the mistake of saying, if you know anything, they'll grow through the cracks. And so, yeah, but they ran over it with their truck. So, oh well, it was worth a shot. I told them they could take them out. Anyhow, well, that's what's up with me. Look at the California poppies are growing right there. They always grow where I don't want them for some reason. It's not supposed to storm today. It's just supposed to be windy like this. And in the 90s, it's insane. I'm not gonna boob, but it's been crazy. Yeah, well, there's that other plant. Geranium. Yeah, geranium. That I got for Mother's Day. Anyhow. I'm so tired. I'm gonna cut some of this pretty soon. Do you guys see the little flowers? I don't know. Maybe I won't cut any this year. I don't know. I'll play it by ear. Sometimes I get myself all tuckered out with stuff that I don't really have to do. Well, I will talk to you guys later. This is going to be my vlog, unless I come up with something to talk about. I just thought I should show you the yard, though, while it's lush and green like this, because we're going to hit 90s now, and our precipitation usually is nothing, hardly anything, then it's not going to stay green like this for long. Dang, I think I'm going to have to throw in sprinklers tomorrow. Alright, bye. Hangnails.